This week's weekly ritual is dedicated to the memory and the music of rockers Johnny Solinger, Brendan STU McGuire, and Bradley Eligius Hart, who all passed away this week. Rest in power. What's up, everybody? It's Keefe, and you're watching the Weekly Ritual Ghost Cults News Show right here on YouTube. If you're new to the channel, please like and subscribe. GhostCultMag.com is a small business. With that out of the way, let's get into it.
In case you missed it, features at Ghost Cult Magazine.
We talked to metal drumming legend Hannes Grossmann. You might know his work from his extensive career in bands like Obscura and The Necrophagist, and most recently Alkaloid and even Triptychon. He's got a brand new solo album out, and we caught up with him to talk all about it. We also caught up with Etienne of Alpha Boötis. The Canadian progressive rock band has a new EP out, Stowaway Ants, and new singles coming out all the time this year. We also talked to post-metal band Sleeping Dreaming all about their recent album. Make sure to check out our preview of all the live streams this month for July. Rock, metal, pop, whatever. We covered a bunch of them. Check it out right here at the link. You still have a few weeks left to win tickets to see Anthrax's 40th anniversary live stream event live from LA from Ghost Cult at the link below.
And now the news rundown.
We start this week's news show off with a heavy heart as we have to mention the passing of several members of the global rock family. Former Skid Row frontman Johnny Solinger passed away after a year-long illness. There was an outpouring of support and love and memories of Johnny all over social media, especially from his former bandmates in Skid Row. Rest in peace, Johnny. We also have to mention the passing of STU McGuire, Brendan STU McGuire, formerly of Bane and Reach the Sky, who passed away after a multi-year battle with pancreatic cancer. There was a series of fundraisers and events held for STU, including one that is to take place today, which will now go to raise money for his family, his widow, and his children. We're very sad to hear this. STU is one of the good guys in all of rock and hardcore, and we are deeply saddened by his loss. We also have to bring you the very sad news of the passing of Bradley Hart of Vancouver metalcore band Blood of the Phoenix. We just did a premiere with that band. Their new album is out now, and Bradley passed away suddenly and unexpectedly. We send our sympathies out to his family and friends, as we do all these rockers. Rest in power. Following up on last week's bombshell news that Blink-182 co-founder Mark Hoppus has been battling leukemia, he gave an update to fans this week. Initially, fans were totally caught off guard and surprised when he posted to his Instagram about getting chemotherapy treatments, and then slowly news leaked out. Members past and present of Blink-182 wished Mark support, but Mark is now updating the fans on his goings-on. He says he has good days and bad days. He is expected to make a full recovery, but right now he's in the midst of getting chemo, and it is sometimes very severe. We'll continue to monitor this and wish for you to get well as soon as possible, Mark. And just fuck cancer in general this week. Just fuck cancer. All the time. Fuck cancer. On to some more positive and uplifting news. Shows and festivals are back, my friends, and we spend the early portion of every week's show updating you on all the festivals and tours that have been announced. We are super stoked for this. Testament, Exodus, and Death Angel will all team up for the Bay Stikes Back US leg of their tour this summer and fall. Super exciting news. Bad Religion has rescheduled their massive US tour in celebration of their 40th anniversary that did not happen last year. Alkaline Trio will provide direct support on all dates. Kicking off this week, the Summerland Tour. Art Alexakis and Everclear's annual summer tour is back this year, finally, and it kicks off this weekend. Everclear, Living Colour, Hoobastank, and Wheatus. We're gonna party like it's 1995, yo. Meshuggah face. That's my Meshuggah face. Meshuggah has announced a headline tour of the US in early 2022. They will be joined by Converge and Torche on these dates, and hopefully we're gonna get news about new Meshuggah music and a new Meshuggah album really soon, because they are in the studio right now. Evanescence and Halestorm have not only announced additional dates for their co-headlining tour, they've announced two openers. PLUSH and Lilth Czar will open special dates each on the tour. Wolfgang Van Halen has announced headline dates with his MammothWVH band on his off dates from the Guns N' Roses headline tour this summer. And last and never least, Limp Bizkit is coming back on a headline tour. It's been almost 10 years since they put out the Gold Cobra record. They've been promising a new record, but they are coming on tour, and they are bringing Spiritbox with them as an opener. What a fun, fun pairing that's gonna be. Or you could just show up early for Spiritbox and, you know, rabbit. It's fine. No, I love Limp Bizkit. It's cool. We're gonna stay. In a story we've been tracking here at Ghost Cult, Marilyn Manson has agreed to turn himself into authorities in New Hampshire for assault charges he's been facing. Very interesting case where Manson has made a deal he may not actually have to physically turn himself in due to social distancing, and there's no real extradition between New Hampshire and California, but Manson has agreed to at least surrender and face the charges against him. No word yet as to what the outcome will be, but according to the state of New Hampshire, assault charges carry a hefty jail term and a fine. Rob Halford, Sammy Hagar, Sebastian Bach, and Lizzie Hale are just some of the artists added to the Bonanza Livestream event celebrating the birthday of Ronnie James Dio, who passed away years ago, but he would have turned 79 on July 10th, and you can watch an incredible Livestream party with the whole world. Tickets are on sale now at RollingLiveStudios.com. Are you a fan of Nirvana? Of course you are! Nirvana has hit 1 billion streams on Spotify for their song Smells Like Teen Spirit, their very first hit single, their first single off of the album Nevermind, the iconic album 30 years old this year, and quite a feat to accomplish getting a billion streams. Probably gonna get $2 for that whole thing. Limit $3.50. Fresh off their appearance at the Download Pilot Fest a few weeks back, Employed to Serve has announced a brand new album, Conquering, and a brand new single and video exist, which you don't want to miss. Iron Maiden has teamed up with Igloo Coolers to create an Iron Maiden cooler with any artwork and everything. It's awesome. It's like 50 bucks, but it's rad if you want to keep your Iron Maiden beers cool. If you need an Iron Maiden cooler when you go back to tailgating, you can get one now at igloo.com. According to published reports, a movie biopic is in the works about the life of former Stone Temple Pilots and Velvet Revolver singer Scott Weiland. This will be based on his memoir, Not Dead and Not For Sale. Weiland passed away 6 years ago. It's hard to believe, December 3rd, 2015. And we're really interested and excited to hear about this film project, which is apparently being headed up by major STP and Weiland fans. Based on the recent success of movies like Bohemian Rhapsody and Rocketman and the US versus Billie Holiday, this is sure to be a movie of interest for rock and music fans everywhere. Machine Head's Rob Flynn, in one of his recent vlogs, has announced that Machine Head will be releasing a new album, most likely next year in 2022. Super exciting news. This is going to be comprised of all their recent digital singles, including the current triple single that's out now. Very cool stuff from Machine Head and Rob Flynn. They've announced that the Burn My Eyes tour is over a few weeks ago, and now they are plotting their next moves. Very exciting stuff. Not an official announcement, but if it came from the man himself, it's probably true. Matt Pike of High on Fire is going to release his very first book, a book of his lyrics illustrated, Head on a Spike, released by Rare Bird Literature. We love those guys. They put out the recent photo book by Jeremy Saffer and the upcoming memoirs from Frank Bello of Anthrax. And so Matt Pike will now have an illustrated book of his lyrics. You can pre-order it at the link below. If you missed the recent live stream performance of Baby Metal, celebrating their 10 years of Baby Metal at Budokan concert, fear not, it's coming back on in a few weeks and you can buy a ticket to watch it. But not only that, if you want to watch it in your own home all the time, it's coming out on DVD and Blu-ray. Get hype! Iconic British doom metal band Orange Goblin has announced the departure of founding member and bassist Martin Millard. After the band played their 25th anniversary shows a few weeks back, Martin has decided to step down from the band. Replacing Martin in the band is none other than Harry Armstrong, the frontman of band Blind River, and he's been on End Level Boss and Hangnail and other British doom bands, so it's a really good fit for them to go with Harry as a new bassist, and we wish Martin the best of luck in retirement. In a story we broke a few months back, High on Plastics has finally released their Gwar action figure for Oderus Urungus. Rest in power, the mighty Oderus. He is getting his very own action figure in three styles. Translucent blue, typical Oderus colored, and of course, another one that's like evil black and red looking. It's $75, and you can order that now from the High on Plastics website. Black Metal Rainbows is the upcoming 400-page anthology of queer, leftist, and other radical voices in black metal. This is awesome, right on the heels of Pride Month. It's gonna have pieces by Eugene Robinson of Oxbow, Paul Masvidal of Cynic, Lena Dawes, the author of What Are You Doing Here, and so many other actual artists in black metal and the black metal scene. This is an amazing sounding project we're really excited about. We brought you the news a few weeks ago that inventive hardcore band Turnstile was releasing their film and short film, Turnstile Love Connection. Well, they did so, and now it's free to watch with the public, and it's got four new Turnstile songs, three of which you have not heard yet, and one, Mystery, which is their recent single. Very exciting stuff for Turnstile. We're hoping to get an announcement of a full new album very soon. Brutal UK band Conjurer, you have to say Conjurer, you have to say it like that. Conjurer has released a new music video for their song Choke from their excellent 2018 album Mire. The band played the Download Pilot Fest a few weeks ago, and they're very soon to announce their full-length new album due out from Nuclear Blast Records. Beartooth released their brand new album Below just recently on Red Bull Records, and the band has announced not only a Livestream concert coming up very soon, but also a graphic novel on our very favorite brand, Z2 Comics, makers of Anthrax's graphic novel, Baby Metal, Steve Aoki, Run DMC, everybody cool. So very good stuff in the Beartooth camp. They're also going on tour real soon. Super, super cool. Alice in Chains guitarist Jerry Cantrell just shot a new music video for the upcoming first single from his new solo album due soon, and Duff McKagan was in the video with him. Duff is on his record, apparently on bass and guitar. Right this second, Alice in Chains is on hiatus. No word as to when they will return. William Duvall is also working on a solo album, so very cool stuff from Jerry Cantrell. New York progressive rockers Four Trips Ahead dropped a brand new single, Remnants, the title track of their upcoming new EP coming later this summer on Dr. Magic Records. Rocker James Gelber dropped a brand new single, The Runaway. It's his second single in recent weeks. He dropped a cover, a metal cover of Richard Marx's Right Here Waiting, the classic 80s ballad. You might know James's work from his time as the guitarist in Hemlock, who we interviewed not too long ago.
I shit you not. Unbelievable stories you can't make up.
This week's I Shit You Not, we're gonna talk about pop star Halsey, cause why not? She rocks. She's not really a rock singer at all, she's a pure pop artist, and she's got great records, and we're always down to support her. She's making her new solo record right now, and it's produced by Nine Inch Nails. That's right, Trent Reznor and Atticus Ross are producing her new album, and right off of their Oscar win for Disney's Soul soundtrack, they went right in the studio to work on her album. They're also apparently working on a whole new Nine Inch Nails record for release next year. Lots of cool stuff going on.
And now for a look at Who Rules It Streaming.
This week's Who Rules It Streaming, we bring you the story of awesome Japanese drummer Yoyoka. She's just a kid, but she plays incredible drums with a wild performance style, covering classic rock and metal. She recently covered Rage Against the Machine, she's covered Led Zeppelin, she's covered everybody you can think of, and her whole family gets in on the covers game on her channel, and recently did a whole full family cover of Nirvana's Breed. So awesome.
And now for a look at some of the music on New Music Friday. Anthropophagous Depravity, Apocalypto, Comatose Music, At the Gates, Nightmare of Being, Century Media Records, Born of Osiris, Angel or Alien, Sumerian Records, The Apocalyptian Reiter, The Divine Horseman, Nuclear Blast Records, In Force, Deep Blue, Self-Released, Feld, The Intimate Earth, Transcending Obscurity Records, Fermenter, Continuance, Metal Assault Records, Funeral Chasm, Omniversal Existence, Aesthetic Death, Lord of the Lost, Judas, Napalm Records, Mondo Generator, Live at Brosnan, Heavy Psych Sounds, Moonspell, 1755 re-release, Extinct, re-release, Napalm Records, Nana War of Steel, Italian Folk Metal, Napalm Records, Nick Oliveri, No Hits at All Volume 7, Heavy Psych Sounds, Noctambulist, The Barren Form, Willow Tip Records, Postcards from New Zealand, City Islands, Mandrone Records, Psychosexual, Unholy Hymns for the Children, Sex Records, The Choir Boys, A Bit of What You Fancy, 30th Anniversary Edition, Off Your Rocka, Raphael Weinroth Brown, Worlds Within Live, Self-Released, Rocking Corpses, Death Blues, Inverse Records, Sewer Fiend, Echoes from the Cistern EP, Dry Cough Records, Steve Whiteman, You're Welcome, Self Records, Sun Crow, Quest for Oblivion, Ripple Music, Various Artists, Black Waves of Adrenochrome, The Sisters of Mercy Tribute, Metalville Records, Year of No Light, Consolamentum, Pelagic Records.
And now, in our mailbag.
This week's mailbag, we feature a special delivery of vinyl from Sacred Bones Records. Sacred Bones, one of the coolest underground record labels there are. We got this awesome EP from Emma Ruth Brundle and Val, the companion to last year's full-length album, They Are Changing People, and this awesome single from Zola Jesus, which not only includes original music by her, but a remix by director David Lynch. So awesome. You made it to the end of the show, so you know what time it is. It's the end. Thanks for watching. GhostCoatMan.com is a small business, and we really appreciate your support, so please smash that like and subscribe button, drop a comment, and tell us what you thought of the show. We really appreciate it. As we say every week at this juncture, it's a tough time in the world, so please, take care of yourselves, take care of each other, and stay fucking metal.